I'm gonna sing, I'm gonna shout, I'm gonna let the reason out that his love goes on forever. I'm gonna take it all the way.
Welcome back to the Maple Minute this Thursday, February the 8th, 2024. I'm Pastor Bill. We're talking about the Holy Spirit, and today the title of our discussion is going to be dinner. Trying to give you one word to help you remember the thoughts of today. So dinner's our word, and should be an easy one for most of the guys to remember. Dinner. Dinner. You know, over in the book of Romans, Paul wrote in Romans chapter 8, verses 26 to 27, he says, in the same way the Spirit helps us in our weakness, we do not know what we ought to pray for, but the Spirit himself intercedes for us through wordless groans. Verse 27, and he who searches our hearts knows the mind of the Spirit, because the Spirit intercedes for God's people in accordance with the will of God. I don't know about you, but prayer is a weak subject for most Christians. And I, even as a pastor, I would like some help with my prayers. You know, I don't always know how I should pray or what I'm supposed to think about a matter, because I know a lot of my thoughts are selfish. But what happens here, according to Paul, is the Holy Spirit in me, living in me, and that's what we talked about last time, he always knows what to pray. He always prays according to the will of God, even when I don't. So, yes, the Spirit can help in our prayer lives. That's the great aspect, and that's what Paul's talking about today. The word Paul used to describe how the Spirit helps us literally means to lend a helping hand. That's what he says there. The word picture is of two people carrying a log, one on either end, each dependent on the other to hold up his end. Now, that may be the word picture. It's probably not a great representation, because you know God's Spirit does more than we do by far. But it also is the same Greek word that appears over in Luke chapter 10, verse 40, a story that we're probably pretty familiar. Martha and Mary and Lazarus are entertaining Jesus, and Martha's going around fixing dinner, and the verse shows her complaint. It says, but Martha, and I skipped a few words just to get it on screen, came to Jesus and asked, Lord, don't you care that my sister has left me to do the work by myself? Grumble, grumble, complain, complain, complain. Tell her to help me. And there's that word help. When Martha appeals to Jesus to get Mary to help her in the kitchen with the preparation of the food, the dinner, it's the same Greek word that appears back in Romans chapter 8, where the Holy Spirit's helping us in our prayers. In the same personal and practical way, we need the Holy Spirit to lend us a helping hand with our prayers. Help we won't find in any earthly plan or program or any other person. You can come to the pastor, you can come to a deacon, you can come to a Sunday school teacher, you can come to your whoever you think is really godly person or could really knows the Bible, but they can't help you the way the Holy Spirit can when it comes to prayer. See, there's this powerful synergy, and if you're not familiar with that word, that means just a combined energy of two people working together, synergy at play. When you combine forces, you get synergy, and it's more powerful than just individual energies. There's this powerful synergy at play when we recognize we have a personal prayer partner with the Holy Spirit. See, the Holy Spirit is not just by our side and on our side. He is alive inside us, and that's the great news. And we talked about a little bit about him being inside, but he does actively help us with our prayers. So what's this got to do with the title dinner? The next time you make dinner, or you set the table for dinner, or you sit down to eat dinner, remember Martha. Remember the way she needed Mary's help in the kitchen. That's the same way that you need the Holy Spirit's help in your prayer life. Remember, ask God to give you a helping hand, because the Holy Spirit, that's what he does. And actually, he does it, and you don't even have to ask. That's the great news. So you can rely on, even if your prayers aren't the best, the Holy Spirit will make them according to God's will. So let's take just a second and think these things through with a few questions. First of all, how is your prayer life, and what could make it better, in your opinion? When do you find it difficult to pray, and why? Secondly, do you think it's easier to ask someone to pray for you or your prayer requests than you do to actually pray? And if so, why? Is it easier to get somebody else to pray for you and your prayer requests, or do you actually do it? Why? And then thirdly, how much of your prayers are filled with religious jargon and things you've heard others pray? why does this happen? And because we know that Jesus warned that that's not a good idea to have that religious jargon, repetition. He said that's what the unsaved people do. And so the good thing we have in our lives is the Holy Spirit who helps clean up our bad prayers. And so don't be worried about your prayer life, because you have a winning combination. You have that synergy, that person who's lending you a helping hand and probably doing most of the heavy lifting, the Holy Spirit living within you. And he's active alongside of us, by our side, on our side, and inside us to do the things that we need so much help with. So hopefully you're growing and learning, and you're moving forward in your life with Jesus Christ. Well, until next time, thanks for joining me here on the Maple Minute. Take it all the way. You're gonna praise Jesus' name, because his love goes on forever. His love reaches to the highest mountain. His love.